Hello everyone, this is your good old neighbor Nick Hicks, Spider-Verse, and Frozen 2 fans. That's one, yo. I am definitely not saying good morning at all today because of the pain way. This has to be one of the worst night I have ever had in my entire life, because this is even worse than 2 years ago. We have my power went off, and that is honestly one of the worst things that happened in 2021. But this is honestly, this is even worse than 2021, the power out. But honestly, it's not because of that. It's because that my brother blasted the music at 3, 4, 5 in the morning. And I was like, are you kidding me for this nonsense? Anyway, honestly, I don't want to tell you about that. It's personal. But anyway, yeah, I'm probably after this review, I might take it down. Because I cannot do anything while I'm working like this. I work awful. I kind of work like Robert, you know, as a grumpy man from The Dirty Grandpa, which the movie sucks. So anyway, guys, so today I'm doing a movie review of Meet the Parents, starring Robert Deano and Ben Schneider. On the guys, the same actor that he was in Madagascar as Alex the Lion. What? Sorry, guys, it came out of year of 2000, the same year of the stupid movie called the Battlefield Earth, which honestly, guys, nobody gave a crap about that movie. And my second favorite movie of the 2000, which is known as the American Psycho, starring Christian Bale. So yeah. Sorry, guys, enough further ado. Let's get this review over with, started, shall we? I just want to make this review short, and I don't want to make this review more longer, because I'm not in the mood for this type of stuff. Honestly, God, I was really going to do a Q&A today, but apparently I had to wait it until tomorrow because apparently didn't have a good night's sleep. So just pray for me, so do I. After this review, I'm taking a nap. So I cannot do anything with my mom while I'm looking at this. And even my mom haven't have a good sleep because of that instead of that, what my brother did, blasting new music at night time. Wait, seriously, you don't do that? What is wrong with you? So hey guys, enough further ado, let's get this review started over with. Honestly, guys, this review is was shout out to Mature, because Mature was recommending to the Meet the Parent franchise. And to be honest, I have never seen this franchise when this movie was released back then, like 23 or 24 years ago. Honestly, God, this film came out in the 2000, the same year of the Elvis New Groove, American Psycho, and that stupid Battlefield Earth, which honestly, God, that film was even worse than Gotti. I would have watched Gotti better than watching Battlefield Earth, more like Battlefield Turd or Battlefield Crap. It's a piece of crap. So, yeah. And so, hey, guys, I have never seen Meet the Parents, so honestly guys, I really hope you're enjoying my DVD unboxing, because I saw this movie, which I'm talking about it right now. I might watch the sequel tomorrow, and I will watch the God Awful third one, which I really know the third one is going to be suck. Honestly, that film looks like The Last Airbenders look like a masterpiece, better than The Widow Parent, which I don't want to talk about the weird title because it kind of made me, I'm saying the F word. So yeah. So hey guys, and after I watched this film for the first time on DVD, which I have a DVD right now with this. What is that anyway? Here it is. Honestly guys, I got this DVD at Walmart, and yes, this type of stuff DVD was selling on Dollar General, but this is a Walmart exclusive. I was really gonna get this film on Amazon, but doing to this film is on Peacock, which honestly guys, I'm not gonna waste my entire time to watch the third one on Peacock. So I just buy a DVD of it, so I just watch all the DVDs of it. So yeah. So you guys, and honestly guys, if it gets sold out because of me, Just go on Amazon and order for Black Friday. That will be your puppet Black Friday. Then go into the stores and find a whole bunch of knucklehead, find all the stupid stuff. So, hey guys, so after I watched Meet the Parent for the first time, all I gotta say, but this is honestly one of the funniest comedy movie I have ever seen in my entire life. Yup, even better than Knife Out. Honestly, guys, even I enjoy Knife Out, but honestly, guys, I think this film is way more funnier than Knife Out. Honestly, guys, this is honestly one of my new favorite movie of the 2000s, because originally it was American Psycho, but Meet the Parent is a really emotional, really heartwarming, and really hilarious movie. And this is honestly one of the best Ben Schneider movie I have ever seen in my life. And Ben Schneider is a great actor. I do enjoy his work. Honestly, I like Madagascar, which is my second favorite performance by Ben Schneider. And honestly, Ben Schneider was in the Blow movie as a cameo, which I probably didn't even know, Mitchell, because Ben Schneider was in the cameo for the Blow movie, which is really a gay movie, which it came out on September last year, which, honestly, it would be a very, honestly, it would be a first year when that film came out, and I might rewatch it for my Ben Schneider marathon, because he was in that film as a cameo, so yeah. And yes, you can spoil the movie, because the movie came out last year, so it's not a big deal. And so, hey guys, and I'm a huge fan of Robert De Niro. Honestly, guys, here's some of the movie I have never seen by Robert De Niro. I haven't seen Taxi Driver. I have never seen The Godfather Part 2. I saw the first one, and I didn't. Honestly, guys, I heard the third The Godfather Part 3 was not even that good. Honestly, not as good as the first and the second. Honestly, I heard the second is the best sequel ever, so I might... Honestly, I might watch that movie because that's a pretty long movie. Like, come on, that movie is a 3-hour movie, which I won't mind it. But 6-hour movie, cowboy movies, absolutely not. I cannot handle that type of runtime. So, yeah. Honestly, I can handle some 1, 2, 3, or even 4 runtime. I cannot handle 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and definitely not 10. Anyway. And so, you guys, and this is... Honestly, guys, this film is way better than Dirty Grandpa. Honestly, guys, the main reason why I think this film is way better than Dirty Grandpa because this film started with Robert De Niro, which I like Robert De Niro. Honestly, guys, I do like him more in the serious role more than in the comedy role. But honestly, guys, this film was honestly one of the best Ben Schneider movies I have ever seen in my life. Honestly, guys, do I have any negative about this film? Nah, I don't have any flaws about this film, but the sequel going to have some flaws, so stay tuned for that. Honestly, guys, let's get so many good things about this film instead of the negative. So, hey guys, honestly, guys, in the story is really amazing, and the character is really lovable and emotional, like Grade, played by Ben Schneider. This is hands down one of my favorite characters in this film. Honestly, guys, he was so hilarious, and honestly, guys, especially for that airplane scene. Honestly, guys, to be honest, this film... It's kind of feel like I'm watching out the one episode from the SML when Marvin say bomb and cop. And the cop would say, hey, you cannot say bomb in the airplane. Honestly, guys, when I was watching this film, would have a reference to the SML. Honestly, guys, this film came out way before the SML. Because the SML came out in 2005, which is a few years ago. This film came out in 2000, so I'm not doing a Phil Whipple claim, I was just saying. Anyway, and that airplane scene, this is honestly one of my favorite scenes of this film. This film is a really hilarious movie. And so, you guys, and Jack, played by Robert De Niro. Honestly, guys, I'm a huge fan of Robert De Niro. I do not like him in Dirty Grandpa, which, screw Dirty Grandpa, that movie will kiss my butt. So, you guys, this is hands down one of my second favorite performances I have ever seen from Robert De Niro, because my favorite performance I have ever seen by Robert De Niro, which is other than him as Murray Franklin, and screw Grace Randolph for hating on that character, which Grace Randolph is such a crazy woman as a movie critic. I do love her as a person, but her as a movie critic, nah. My girlfriend at school is much better girlfriend than Grace Randolph, my opinion. So yeah, guys, and Grade girlfriend was the one who going to marry in the second film. She was amazing. She's only one of my favorite female character crush of the 2000s. She's such a beauty. I really love her. So, yeah. And so, hey, guys. And we got Jack, wife, played by the same actress, which I didn't even know. Honestly, guys, she's a... She was an amazing character. I do love her. Do love her. And we got Obis Wilson. Honestly, guys, if you're a huge fan of Cars, this film is your favorite because honestly, Obis Wilson, played by Lightning McQueen and played by Morbius from The Rookie Show. No, people, I'm not talking about the god-awful Morbius. That is honestly one of the worst movies of 2022 in the history of mankind. Yeah, that film sucks. I might do a video about why Morbius ruined the Spider-Man universe. Honestly, guys, and... the Kuwait Hunter was originally going to be released in this year, but it got delayed due to the writer strike. But honestly, when the writer strike over, movie will go back to the release date, and I do not want to hear none of the nonsense ever again. And so, you guys, and that's all I care to I know about this film. So, you guys, and the cinematography was really pretty good, honestly, and the score. I didn't even know Winnie Newman did a score in this film. Because, honest guy, when I was watching the opening, and I heard Winnie Newman is, was singing the song about this film, and I was like, honestly, guys, this is the very first time and I see Winnie Newman in a PG-13 movie. Honestly, guys, I'll probably normally see him in a rated G and a rated PG Pixar film, but now he's in a rated PG PG-13 film. Yep, what are you gentlemen? We got Winnie Newman in a PG-13 movie. Yep. Honestly, guys, I will be laughing my butt off that he do a song in the Weather Dog movie. Or even better, in 6-7-8. No, just kidding. Anyway, guys, here's the shot of the movie when Mama Diano characters was telling the truth or lie about Ben Snyder characters. And he using that machine. They use a marking of that. And use a scratching on Ben Snyder's wrist and put him in the finger trap on it. Honestly, guys, I was originally think that is a hooding trap, but no, it was a true and white, and that is a pretty cool machine, by the way. So yeah, guys. Anyway, in the ending of the film is really amazing. And the cat, honestly, I'm not a cat person because dog is way better than cat. Honestly, I might make it a comedia tab, which animal is better, cat and dog. So I might do that in my comedia tab after I take my nap. Anyway, so over guys, Meet the Parent is a fantastic movie. What a funny humor, amazing story, so many emotional. And honestly guys, indie acting is honestly one of the best acting I ever seen for a comedy movie. And Ben Snyder and Robert De Niro all a great duo for a comedy movie. And this is way better than Dwayne Johnson and Kevin Hart as a duo comedy. Honestly, guys, even I love Mila Kunis and Christian Bale as a comedy duo. But honestly, guys, let's face it. Honestly, guys, The Bad Mom 2 is a stupid movie. It's a stupid Christmas movie. Honestly, guys, that film was so stupid. So, yeah. So, hey, guys, and this is honestly one of the funniest comedy movie I have ever seen in my life. And this is honestly one of my favorite movie of 2000. Sorry, Cheryl. American Psycho is my second favorite, but now Meet the Parent is much better. Yep, Meet the Parent beat American Psycho. Yep, you gotta be careful, American Psycho. That's what you get. And so, hey, guys, I am giving Meet the Parent a 10 out of 10. This is epic, brilliant masterpiece. And I'm giving this hilarious movie a seal of Nick Cage awesomeness. Sorry, guys, that was my movie review of Meet the Parent, aka one of my favorite movie of the 2000 decade. Honestly, guys, this film is even better than Avatar's, Spirits Away, or even better than The Dark Knight. Honestly, guys, this is how good this film is. And if you haven't seen this film, what on earth are you doing? Go see this. Honestly, go watch this film and go buy this film on DVD because I have the film on DVD and I really hope this film will come out on 4K. Sorry again, that was my movie review of Meet the Parent. Honestly, guys, tell me what your opinion on this film on the comments section below. And now, I don't feel like doing Q&A. This is the video you're gonna get. I just not in the mood right now. Didn't have a good night's sleep, so I'm just taking a nap. Sorry, guys, if you like this video, if you want to enjoy more of this, please, I highly recommend you hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, and share the video with your whole family. And stay tuned for my movie review of Meet the Parent 2. Honestly, guys, I'm not going to say what the real title is, because the real title kind of feel like I'm saying the F word. Honestly, guys, for now on, if I do a sequel called Meet the Parent 2, honestly, guys, stay tuned for my movie review of Meet the Parent 2. Yes, people, not going to say his gray last name, because his gray last name was really, honestly, guys, was called Raga. Honestly, guys, stay tuned for my movie review of Meet the Quara. Meet the Quara. I meant to say. Meet the Quara. So, yeah. Honestly, guys. I already know that sounds stupid, but honestly, guys, this is way better than saying the F word. Yeah, screw the F word, and that is honestly one of the worst bad word I ever heard in my entire life. That is even worse than the S word, the B word, and even worse, the A word, which we don't want to talk about that. And honestly, I don't want to go back in my timeline when I used to cuss on my video. Yeah, that make my video ugly. So, hey, guys, and tell me what you, and honestly, guys, then tell me what your favorite comedy movie of all time. Comment below and let me know, and stay tuned for my Q&A maybe tomorrow if I have a good night's sleep. And I really hope my parrot went off, and I really hope my brother Chris won't blast the music, because I was so loud and I did not, and honestly guys, I was not having a happy camper, Mr. Seth. So you guys, subscribe, comment, Share the video with your family. And this film is getting anniversary on October 6th, so I just watched this movie anyway because I was getting bored. So, hey guys, and I really hope you enjoy my redo movie review of Fast and the Furious 10, as stated for my movie review of Indiana Jones and the Tower of the Destiny, because, honestly, guys, the digital is going to come out on August 28th, so I might have a boys' night, and honestly, guys, I am so scared about that film. It's going to be my worst movie of the year. I really hope not, because I really hope that film will be even better than the last one we got back then, 15 years ago. So, yeah. Yeah, honestly, guys, screw that one movie that came out 15 years ago, which is a disaster movie. Yeah, screw the movie. That was honestly one of the worst movies I have ever seen in my entire life. So, hey, guys, I'll see you next time. And so long, and peace, YouTube. Mitchell, thank you so much for recommending and stay tuned for my movie review of Meet the Foie Gras.
From my kung fu grip, then you can come and have it, okay? Otherwise, step off.
Get off of me! Get off!